Welcome to another installment on fixing up my KP startup. This video is going to cover all the panel beading I've done on the shell, just on the shell. I haven't touched any of the bolt-on panels yet, but panel beaded out the rear quarters. Both sills needed a bit of attention, so going to go over that. This is an area that I'm not experienced in, but learned a bit off reading things and watching videos, so gave it a good shot. It's turned out pretty good, which I'm pretty happy with. So there's not too much left to do before I can start putting the car in paint, which I can't wait for, to be honest. It's going to be nice to start piecing it back together. So this video will just cover the panel beading, and I'll show you what I have done that I haven't filmed, and there's a few things I'm still going to do that I'm not going to film because it's not video worthy, to be honest. So I'll go over that, and then hopefully the next video will be painting it, which is exciting for me. Sit back and take a watch. Hopefully you like what you see and learn a few things. I know I learn a shitload, to be honest, just doing this, so it's pretty cool. So yeah, have a watch. Cheers. As I've mentioned in some of the earlier videos, there's a bit of panel beading to do on this car, and a lot of it I can just do with a hammer and dolly, but a fair bit of it I can't, mainly because you can't get to the back of a lot of the panels. So when I fixed up my old camper, I struggled with a lot of stuff, and I made up for it with bog, to be honest, which is not really ideal, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. So I've been saving a bit of money, and on a recommendation from my mate Alex at ADM Refinishing in down in Blenheim, saved some money and bought myself a bit of a dent puller. So it's just turned up today, so I'm going to unpackage it and start having a to-do with it. Pretty excited, to be honest. So this is a GYS brand dent puller. I've got no experience with this sort of stuff, but I realised I needed something to help me
fix up this body. So yeah, put a bit of money aside to buy it on recommendation. I was just going to buy something cheap off eBay, but once I sort of priced them up, I thought it was a bit better just to put a bit more money into it and buy this, which, to be fair, wasn't that bad. It was about $1,000 all up, which is all good. It's basically that's like a little stick welder, I suppose, a little stick welding unit, and then has this attachment here, this handgun, which a slide hammer attaches to, and have a few different attachments. So basically what you do with this is spot weld these tabs in here, you spot weld it to the car and use a slide hammer to pull dents out. Also bought these wiggle wires, which you weld the entire thing along. It's for pulling out seams or creases, like long creases. So should be bloody good actually. There's a lot of small dings I need to get out, and some worse damage as well. But yeah, this is going to do the trick. Pretty bloody happy. I actually need to make a new trolley for my MIG welder, so I might make a trolley that houses the both of them together, seeing they sort of get used for the same job. It's going to be a bit of a learning curve to use it, but surely it can't be too hard. Weld and bang and cut and yeah, should be sweet. So I've just chucked it in my MIG welder trolley at the moment. This is the trolley I want to remake. This is just one of those cheap ones and it's crap. The wheels are stuffed and it's pretty bent, but it's all good for now. So I've just chucked it under there, set it all up. So weirdly, the earth is just a tab, it doesn't come with a clamp. So I guess it's maybe so you can bolt it on, but anyway, I've just clamped the earth on and set the gunning, as you call it, up. So the idea is, I'm going to start here on the sill, just at least it's a part you don't really see, but there's a big crease there and a big dent there, which is by the look of it from a forklift. So I need to pull those dents out, and there's no way to get in there except cutting it open, which I don't want to do. So the idea behind these is the tip of that triangle there, I can spot weld that to the panel, and by using a slide hammer pull the dent out. So gonna give it a go and see how it turns out. So just had a quick little go on that crease there, got a bunch of it out. I think I've just realised I probably need to clean it up a little bit more than what it is. Some of the times it wasn't sticking very well, so I think getting it, although that is bare metal, but getting it real nice and clean will help the process for sure. So I'm just going to go back over this and make sure I get all the paint off and all the crap off and then have another shot. So I've pulled out that front crease pretty good, and tried to pull out this forklift damage and realised it's a bit harder than I thought. So I'm going to have a go with this wiggle wire. So essentially what you do with this is it'll get welded along the crease, and then in all the parts that touch, and then it gives you a whole array of points to pull and try and pull that whole crease out. It is a reasonable dent, but both sills have got it, so I have to work on it to get them out. So see how we go with this little wire. that wiggle wire was a bit of a failure as well, so I think I'll actually have to just resort to welding something to it and using a slide hammer to pull it out, which is all good. It's a pretty gnarly crease, so I think that's more designed for, you know, for little dents, like it did quite well on that. So I think I'll just have to resort to welding something to there and slide hammering it, which is all good. So I'm going to carry on and have another go on some of the smaller dents and see how I go. Pulled out a bunch of spots and beat out a few spots with a hammer and dolly. Now, this stuff's all pretty new to me, to be fair. Done a fair bit of research and a lot of watching of YouTube videos and stuff, so sort of half probably know what I'm doing. So obviously using this new machine I brought, which is pretty stoked on already. And another thing that I've learnt from other YouTube videos, made this stainless disc up for a grinder. They call them shrinking discs, and I've just had a go. This is the first time I've actually used it. Just had a go up here. The idea of these is you beat all the any dents or any stretched area. You beat them out, bring them up, and then by running over them with the shrinking disc, this will just run on all the high spots, heats those high spots up, and then just by wiping with a moist rag, cooling it down, it'll shrink all those high areas. So I just gave it a quick run over here. It seemed to do a little bit, so I'm going to go over this and see if I can shrink down some of these stretched areas. Normally when you, like, there's been a bit of damage on this over the years when I stripped it down. If you remember back quite a few videos, there was a big patch of bog in here, so when a body panel does get dented, it tends to get stretched quite a bit. So to get it back to where it needs to be, it's got to be shrunken, obviously. So this is one method, the shrinking disc. The dent pull has actually got a function on it for shrinking, which I haven't had a go with yet, but I might have a go at some point as well. But from the videos I watched, these shrinking discs seem like a good way to do it, so I'm gonna have a go, see how we go.
Sting of all the truth, was your temple left in ruins? like Omega. Quiet and shielded, all intent on the ground, it appears like a wrath of engine.
I got this back quarter, finally, where I'm pretty happy with it. It was a mission getting the seam back straight. Still looks a bit crap here, but that's just more from the beading marks on it. I think I actually over shrunk this bit in here, so the last bit I was doing there, just hammer on dolly just to try and stretch it out and get this body line good, and it's pretty good. Might be ever so slightly in just around here, but which is actually probably good, because I can't shape this perfectly, so it will need a skimmer bog. So pretty happy with it. There's a little bit up here I had to pull out. This part here is a bit rough. That's where at some stage in this car's life it had a quarter put on, and I pulled a bit out around here. Now right in that bottom corner there, I can't get a dolly in there, so I've just pulled out as good as I could and tapped the highs down. That's good enough with a slight skimmer bog in it. So pretty happy with the side now. There might be the odd little bit I notice later on, but it's turned out good. So here. So I move to the other quarter now, which is way worse than this one. So it was good to give the dent puller a run, see how it goes, learn a few things, try some stuff. So hopefully I can make a reasonable job of the other side too. Same deal as this one, it's crap right in the center there. So I really need to put a bit of effort in, because that body line is pretty crucial to make it look good. So I can put a bit of bog in there if I have to, but I'd rather not put a shitload in. It's definitely not metal finished, but it's pretty good for how it was. As you can see, I've done my first lot of dent pulling on this side. There's a shitload in it. It's actually already looking a hell of a lot better. It looks pretty bad, but it was pretty caved in. You can see that guard there. I never actually finished grinding the welds off, so that needs to be done. If there is access to the back of these guards in there and one at the front, but you really can't get a good swing in to try and push the panel back out. So that's why I'm using the dent puller, and then now that I've got it roughed out, I'll go in with the hammer and dolly and flatten it all out. If you could get to the back really well and get a good swing, you'd just push it out with the hammer, it'd be a hell of a lot easier. Like if it was a front guard door, for instance, it'd be easy, but because that access is pretty hard, that dent puller's actually been awesome. Like I said, this guard is pretty bad. There was a big gouge in here from before I owned it, obviously. And this back quarter was real stuffed, so it's a bit to get it straight, but I think it's actually going to get there, which I'm pretty stoked about. I sort of thought it might have been it's a bit too stretched to get it good, but I think it's going to happen. So, yeah, so now I'm going to go in with the hammer and dolly, hit down all these highs, all the little pimple-looking things that's from the dent puller, so I'm going to hit those down. And flatten everything out, and then I'll probably just give it a scuff with a file or a bit of sandpaper and just see where the lows are and carry on pulling out. And then once it's pretty much roughed out, try and get that body line straight. Obviously need to grind those welds like I just said, and still a little bit to do on that flare just on the inner side of it. This bottom here needs a bit of work, so yeah, it's getting there. Yeah.
my mom was late, so I had to plan my escape out the skins in this world to fly girls. Tangeray and Hennessy until I call Earl. 10 months in this gut, what the fuck? I wish Mars would hurry up so I could get fucked. Wild juvenile ripping mics and shit. New York, New York, ready for the likes of this. Then came the worst date, May 21st. 2019, that's when my mama wore the burst. No spouse in the house, so she rode herself to the hospital to see if she could get a little help. Umbilical cords wrapped around my neck. I'm seeing my death, and I ain't even took my first step. I made it out, I'm bringing mad joy. The doctor looked and said he's gonna be a bad boy.
Me all the respect to all the gunman them. Gunman alone keep gunman friends. Fireman, me all the informer them. Gunman alone keep informer friends.
Now I'm 13, smoking blunts, making cream. On the drug scene, fuck the football team. Risking ruptured his spleens by the age of 16. Hearing the coach scream ain't my lifetime dream. I mean, I wanna blow up, stack my dough up. So school, I didn't show up and fuck my flow up. Mom said that I should grow up and check myself before I wreck myself, disrespect myself. Put the drugs on the shelf, nah, couldn't see it. Scarface, king of New York, I wanna be it. Rap was secondary, money was necessary. Until I got incarcerated, kinda scary. C-74, Mark 8, set me straight. Not able to move behind the great steel gate. Time to contemplate, damn, where did I fail? All the money I stacked was all the money for bail.
Me a lot of respect to all the gun man them. All of the gun man them keep gun man friend. I'm my fun, me a lot of informer them. Informer alone keep informer friend. Me a collect to all the gun man them. Gun man alone keep gun man friend. I'm in on one, me a lot of informer them. We are the informer alone keep informer friend.
94, now I explore new horizons. Mama smile when she see me, that's surprising. Honeys is tantalizing, they freak all night. Keep ducking cops on the creep all night. As I open my eyes and realizing I changed, not the same deranged child stuck up in the game. And to my niggas living street life, learn to treat life to the best. Put stress to rest, still tote your vest, man. Niggas be tripping in the streets without a gap. Nah, nigga, you slipping. If I'm dipping on the F with weed on my breath, original hustler with the muffler on the tech. Respect to the max and the axe, to the freaks and the jeeps. Next shots from a beat.
Me a lot of respect to all the gun man them.
All of the
gun man
them.
Keep gun man friend. I'm my friend. Mercy, mercy, mercy. Informer them. Informer alone keep informer them. Me a collect to all the gun man them. Gun man alone keep gun man
friend. I'm in on one. The party and everybody feel irate and everybody just follow me, follow me, follow me. Have mercy, the whole of we in the party and everybody look irate. Now the man them sexy, sexy, sexy. Do it.
No mercy for the bigger.
I got these two recorders now to a point where I'm pretty happy. Not perfect, but for what they were and for what they are, pretty good. A little bit bummed this bottom quarter here. I just can't get to the rear of it at all. There's a bracket in here for the jack, and I can't get a dolly in at all. So it's still a bit crap down there, but it's just what it is. So it turned out pretty good. Body line's reasonable, not perfect like I said, but a bit of bog and Hi-Fall primer on it and should be able to get it reasonable. So that side's good, and same with the other side. Well, they're good to the point I'm happy to call them good anyway. So now I'm going to move on to try and get these dents out of the sill. Like I saw before, I couldn't use the dent puller. They're a bit too badly dented, so I'm just going to use a slide hammer and weld on a bit of flat bar to pull off. So hopefully get them out. So you can see the damage in these sills. Pretty sure the car's been picked up by a forklift at some stage, which is pretty common. So it's two forklift marks to pull out. Obviously you don't really see these, but it is a structural part of the car, so it needs to be straight and likely would fail a warrant with big dents. So I'm going to pull it out. So what I'm going to use is, because the dent puller is not strong enough, so I'm going to use my slide hammer that I made and just weld this tab into the places, which the slide hammer just screws into that nut there. So it's a bit more tedious to do it this way, because you've got to weld it on, pull it out and cut it off and move it. But it's the only way to get a good yank on them. There's obviously, well, if I could, I can't even show you. If I could, I'd get into the back of the sills and hammer it out, but that won't work. So this is the option. So let's see how I go. That is panel beading of the body done, I suppose. I will go back around the car, and I'm sure there'll be little bits that I've missed and little bits I want to tidy up a bit more. But yeah, for the most part, that's it. I didn't film any of this because it would have made pretty crap video, but all the sound deadening's gone from in here. I've wire wheeled the whole lot, cleaned up a bunch of stuff. So yeah, there's a couple little things I want to do still. It's just all the old glue and stuff that I need to get rid of. A few little things I haven't pulled off, like some wiring that's been dangling there since I pulled it apart. But yeah, it's looking pretty good in here. Very well, very nearly good enough to start putting some primer on. Started sanding the engine bay, which I'm going to carry on with. I think I've said before, but I actually redid this engine bay not that long ago, maybe a couple of years or so. So I know what's under there. It's all pretty good. I took it back to bare metal when I did it the first time. And now I actually did prang it, drifting it, but I know it's good. There's there's nothing hidden that I'm worried about. So I'm happy just to sand it up and paint that. I'll flip the car over and show you. Stripped all the underseal from the underside of the car, so I'll just flip the car up and we'll have a look there. As you can see, I've stripped the underbody pretty substantially. All the sound deadening, or the, I don't know what you call it, yeah, sound deadening I suppose, is all gone. All the underseal. So you have to just give this a bit of a wire wheeling and scuff it up, ready for painting as well. It was actually all pretty good, all the underseal, but I just really wanted to just make sure everything was good, since I've gone this far with the car. So once everything's all scuffed up and wire wheeled and I'm happy with everything, first step will be to put the entire body in epoxy primer, so inside, outside, underneath, everything. A bit of rust will go in a few places it needs to go, just to prevent anything. I'll be cavity waxing all the cavities, under seal, under here again, re-under seal all that. I've got a whole lot of Dynamat style product to go on the inside, so going pretty all out, which hopefully at the end of the project it's a real nice car to drive on the road, which will be exciting because I've only ever had loud ass old school cars that have been pretty painful to drive hours on end, which I've done anyway. There's a few other things. I repaired a whole lot of holes that were in this spare wheel well, which I didn't show, that had just had holes drilled and cut all through it, as you can see. So it's very nearly there. I'm just trying to make sure I don't miss anything, or think of things after it's painted, which obviously sucks. So yeah, just gonna go over it a few times, make sure I've done what I need, and then gonna paint it in the shed. I've got a temporary gazebo thing that can stick up in here, fits inside, and paint it in here. I did it for the van, it worked out alright, just need a bit of ventilation. So as you can see, I'm getting through all these jobs. It's been a long process. I haven't gone as hard as I probably would have had it not been winter. Where I live, it's pretty cold in winter, so it can be hard to drag yourself out into the shed late at night and whatnot. So yeah, I've been going hard where I can, and it's getting there. Can't wait to get this thing back on the road. Really want to, just have one of my projects going would be nice, and be good to get back into the 626. I'm sure plenty of you guys be keen to see some more progress on that. Thanks for watching. Next video, like I said, is going to be about painting it, I think. Well, priming it, not painting it, priming it. I have decided on not an exact colour, but a colour I like. I'll show you it maybe once I get some paint. a colour that I haven't seen one of these painted, I don't think. It's a colour I've seen on other cars, and I like it. I sort of thought I'm putting this much effort into the car, I'd like to paint it a colour that that you don't really see them in. There's plenty of colours that they come in that I really like, but I thought, like I said, all this effort, might as well paint it a colour that's a bit different. So, thanks for watching. Look out for the next one. Cheers.